dragon without its rider is a tragedy. A rider without their dragon is dead. Welcome to the Fourth Wing.
Here's how to pronounce the dragon names in Fourth Wing. If you didn't know, most of the dragon names are actually Scottish Gaelic words. I am a Scottish Gaelic speaker and this is how you actually pronounce them. I'll start with the big one. Violet's dragon is called Tarnionach. Tarnionach. And this is the Gaelic word for thunder. And in the book it's quite often shortened to Tarn. Tarn. This isn't a dragon's name, but I think it's a really good example of how easy it is to get Gaelic wrong. So the name of the college is Basgiath. I don't know how the author wants it pronounced, but it's actually two Scottish Gaelic words, bas and skia. Bas means death and skia means wing. So you can see how it makes sense to have a dragon college called Deathwing. Unfortunately, if you don't put the accent on the A in bas, it doesn't mean death, it means palm, as in the palm of your hand. So instead of meaning Deathwing, it means palm wing, which sounds like a holiday resort rather than a deadly dragon college. There is also another dragon called Andarn Uram. Andarn Uram. And this is actually three words, Andarna Uram, which means the second honour. And in the book, it's quite often shortened to Andarna. There are three other dragons that were introduced to quite early on. I'm still not finished the book, please don't spoil it for me. And those are Amisher, Amisher, which means weather, Chenye, or Chene, which means fire, and Ka, which means battle. Ka. There are lots of other Gaelic dragon names and Gaelic words used in this book, which is really interesting. So I feel like authors often go for Irish Gaelic or Gaeligate when they're writing fantasy books. So it's really nice to see my language represented in a book that's currently a bestseller. Unfortunately, there are lots and lots of grammatical mistakes and spelling mistakes with the Gaelic in this book, which is a shame. I don't think that that's the author's fault. I think the publishers should have hired a language consultant for this, but I am really loving the book and I can't wait to see what happens at the end.
Give me one margarita, I'ma open my leg. Give me two margaritas, I'ma give you some head. Give me three margaritas, I'ma put...
Pick me. Choose me. Love me.
You know, sometimes it's just best to shut the fuck up.
Into the wild, I run.
You met Gavin in Calabasas?
I didn't just meet him. We kissed a little.
No!
It's a white flag, and you may as well start waving it right now,
Leslie.
The only
thing I will be waving is your decapitated head on a stick in front of your weeping mother.
You've probably seen her everywhere. She's on the streets. She's on every billboard. I'm gonna tell you why. Because I just got done reading Fourth Wing by Rebecca Yarros, and I have some words. There are a lot of things I could say about this book, about like the tropes or just like how the vibes were immaculate. But what I want to tell you is that this book is so 2010 in the best fucking way. Do you remember how I felt fucking booking it off that school bus to get home, to jump into your book, whether it was Twilight, The Hunger Games, Divergent, because you were so immersed in the fantasy that this little reality, it just wasn't doing it anymore. That's what this bitch right here does. That's why she's plastered on every billboard. The beginning was giving Divergent. It was giving Dauntless with dragons. That's right, dragons. And they all have their own sassy little personality. For everyone who's saying, this is overhyped. Something is not overhyped just because you didn't like it. This book slapped, okay? Even being dramatic when I say this is who I am now, baby. Yeah. Like, actually read this book though. Read it or else.
Okay, cool.
Hey, be safe.
Yeah.
Be safe. I'll be so safe.
You guys stop me.
Stop. I'm gonna kill you. But how would that keep us safe?
Please tell me you don't have a crush on a fictional character.
He love me, he give me all his money. That Gucci Prada comfy, my sugar daddy.
Gang, how the hell am I supposed to figure out what fourth wing quadrant I'm in? I mean, I read a lot, and I'm trying to write my own books, so am I a scribe?
Hype has gotten to me, I'm reading fourth wing, and I'm to share my reactions as I do. All I know going in is that this is a new adult fantasy, there's dragons, and there's disability rap. Also, I heard it's very focused on the romance, which is honestly what I need right now. So let's just start reading. I'm off strong, the following test has been faithfully transcribed. That's fun, I like that. I don't want to put my tabs where I'd normally put them because it's just so pretty and I don't want them sticking out there. So I'm gonna put them on the top and let's see how that goes. So I read 5 pages. And then did not pick it up for 4 days. Instead, I read a little bit of Send Me to Sleep, which is so good. But that's not what we're here for. Let's get back to Fourth Wing. That old book of folklore about dark-wielding vermin and their wyvern. That's gonna be important.
My hair is the only thing about me that's perfectly healthy. I have never related to something more. Although I don't even think I can say my hair is perfectly healthy. Except when sleeping. It's an executable offense to attack any cadet while sleeping. Article 3, yes, but that doesn't mean you're safe at night. Well, yeah, it's like what Weiland said in Sets of Crows. Just wake them up. They're talking about Dane, and I think I got mildly spoiled for this. I saw a video, and I scrolled as soon as I realized I was being spoiled, but someone was talking about how they didn't like Dane, so I don't think we can trust him. That said, they could just not like him, because they just don't like him. And, like, honestly, in the one paragraph I've read about him, I don't like him solely because I don't trust men. That might be a me problem. Doing well and he'll keep you safe. No, he won't, because I don't trust him. I've decided I don't like him. Okay, so I'm guessing her real love interest, whose name is Zayden. I've seen it in a lot of videos. It's with an X. I'm guessing that he's going to be a set in her third year, because she was just told that she can't sleep with set in her third years. So, of course, her love interest is going to be one. That's just my prediction. This whole parapet thing just reminds me of jumping off the roof into the net into Dauntless in Divergent. That Zayden Ryerson. He's a third year and he will kill you the second he finds out who you are. I was right. I knew he'd be a third year. And the whole killing thing, they'll get over that. I'm sure. That's not going to be a problem.
Dragon without its rider is a tragedy. A rider without their dragon is dead. Welcome to the Fourth Wing.
Shut up, it is not.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
The only heir to the throne is dead.
Sorrows. Sorrows, prayers.
Andy, are you okay?
Oh, I'm fine. It's just that life is pointless and nothing matters, and I'm always tired. Also, I can't sleep. I'm overeating. None of my old hobbies interest me.
It's all right. Oh my God, I almost died!
No.
I almost died! It was so scary! Thank you!
It's okay. It's all right. It's all right.